in the late 50s, through the next decade and beyond. It was not a question of aid, in his view, but rather one of a fundamental democratic human right of parents to send their children to the school of their choice. Thousands of Australians of all persuasions owe him a singular debt for the principles he helped to establish on their behalf. His vigour and dynamism in pleading for this right at dozens of school opening ceremonies and here at a journalist's club luncheon in 1971 in Hobart became legendary.
I am fighting for hundreds, at the very least, at this moment in Tasmania, of Tasmanians like you, whose fathers fought for this country, who have worked as hard as any Tasmanians to build this state, who are decent people and are paying 70% of their pay envelope to exercise the right of sending their children to a Catholic school in an industrial area, who have not had fruit on their table for the last 4 years. Who have a meagre ration of meat and live mainly on potatoes. That is what I am fighting for. I am not fighting for a monolithic totalitarian structure called the Catholic Church. I am fighting for a basic human right. These people are not sending their children to that school because I threaten to excommunicate them, because I don't. In fact, I've called some of them and said, you just cannot bear the load any longer, and they've broken down and wept.
Here at St. David's Anglican Cathedral, the funeral cortege paused while clergy and students from St. Michael's Collegiate School and other Anglican schools stood silently. The Dean of Hobart gave a blessing.
Rest eternal grant him, O Lord, let light perpetual shine upon him.
And the bells of Hobart's city.